All right, so real quick, I just want to kind of show people kind of what I do for programming. All right, so if you take a look at here, I kind of have like the calendar set up, right? From today all the way to October 13th through 16th, I believe, and that's going to be the weekend of Raw Nationals. So judging from this week, which is October 9th, I have it all set up on the Sundays, right? From that week all the way to this Sunday, which is today, July 31st, I have about 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, about 11 weeks, right? Before the meet. So if the last week is the meet week, and on the week before, you don't really want to be hitting heavy, the heaviest week should either be on the 20, on this week, or on this week, right? And since this is raw, I need less recovery time in terms of how heavy it is, so I'm gonna hit it on this week. Normally for equipped, I'll probably hit my heaviest week on this week. So how I did it was, the numbers that I want to hit are roughly here. I'll just briefly type it down. 525 on the squats, 342 on the bench, and then 622 on the deadlift. Now this is going to be my raw total. Now recently I hit a 500 raw squat and it felt pretty easy. I hit a 331 pause bench and a 600 deadlift, and all of these were all the numbers that I hit recently. You can find on my Instagram, and they're you know, the Instagram Hmong Powerlifter. They were roughly pretty easy. So I'm guessing these numbers right here are good goals for these next week to train for. Does that make sense? Now, if any of those, the 600, the 330, and the 500, in terms of difficulty, smoothness, how it felt, you know, all of that stuff plays into consideration of the numbers that I will pick for this meet. Now again, let's just say if I squatted that 500 and it was like the biggest grinder of my life, of course I wouldn't even put 525. The number that I will aim for at the meet would then be 500. Now again, if 500 was a grinder and the 330 pause bench press was smooth, maybe I wouldn't even attempt a 330 at the meet. I might end up attempting like a lesser weight, let's say 320, because again, if I'm struggling on my squat, right? There's a good chance that if the training doesn't go perfectly well, that 500 is still going to be a grinder. So that could also mean that if I waste so much energy on that third attempt 500, my bench might not go so smooth. So even though I did pause 330 already, it's a good idea for this meet to kind of go a little bit more conservative. And then same thing for the deadlifts. Now, how I do it is I work backwards. Now, let's just say from this week, no matter what, I would like to hit around like 94 to 96% of this weight right here. So let's just say this is 95%. If I could hit 95% for 2 reps, roughly, there's a good chance that during the day of the meet, this should happen, if that makes sense. Now, again, the 525 is just a goal that I want. It doesn't necessarily mean 525 is going to go up during the day of the meet. Depending on how this number goes, right, is going to be dictated based upon what number I will pick for number 3. And of course, I don't really care about third attempts. This is just for reference point. Depending on what I choose as my possible openers will determine what kind of number I will get at the end of this number, or at the end of the meet, if that makes sense. So I work backwards. If this is 95%, I want to be able to hit it for doubles, and vice versa. Slowly taking a few percentage back and work all the way up to today. So as you can see, this is kind of like the template I have for working towards Raw Nationals. Starting today, I want to be able to squat 395 for fives, possibly hit 255 for fives for pauses, and hit a 465 by 5 deadlifts. And as you can see, every 3 weeks I rotate or I drop the reps. So for the next 3 weeks, everything's gonna be fives, which is gonna suck. The next 3 weeks after that is gonna be triples, right? And then the last 3 weeks leading up to my heaviest numbers are just all gonna be doubles. I mean, I like singles, but for me personally, I think doubles work better for me. So again, everybody's going to be a little different. You kind of want to, this is one of the reasons why I wanted to talk about this too, is because the thing about writing your own program and figuring things out, you yourself will know in the future if this is going to work well for you. In the past, I used to always do these last 2 weeks for singles, and then I end up doing very bad in the meet. I found out that if I hit whatever I want for doubles at the end of my training cycles, I usually build a lot of confidence, you know. I mean, imagine if I hit 500 for a single, and then I know I got another 25 pounds left to do at the meet. That's going to cause like a lot of, I guess you can say, anxiety towards that number. So why not go for a double? And hopefully, if training goes well, then I'll feel way more confident with this number. Of course, starting from this week on, all of these will be monitored. At any point when these look a little bad in terms of technique, or if it feels a little bad in terms of how heavy it is, then that means this week is going to be a different number, leading all the way up to 500 times 2 for my squat. See, this number right here might not even happen based off of how these numbers feel. And that's just really quick on how I program my numbers leading up to this raw meet. Again, raw is way easier to kind of try to figure out what you really want to do, so I kind of just briefly did it real quick. Of course, if anybody knows me, this is just the main three lifts, you know. I usually spend another 2 or 3 hours during the same day and on other days outside of just these main lifts to really make sure that this number, if that's really what's inside my heart or what I really want, will happen. And all that depends on how hard you work. All right. So that's just very brief on how I wrote out my program leading up to Raw Nationals.
Come on, come on, come on.